Which is the best M4 for you? Which one should you buy? Which one do you think you'd enjoy the most? Let's find out. The BMW M4 is one of the most popular M cars ever made, and for good reason. It is a fantastic car. It's pretty much a 3 Series, but a coupe version and a coupe of the M3. Now, all of the models come with one engine. It's a 3-liter inline 6 turbocharged engine. But obviously, throughout the different models, they've been changed, upgraded, vamped up, and they've done a lot of stuff with them. So if you look at it the way I look at it, you'll actually find out that you get 11, that's right, I said 11 different types of M4s. Let's go through all of the different types of them quickly, discuss some specifications, power differences, and all different kinds of things like that. And then at the end of this video, we'll kind of help decide which one you think should be best for you. So let's go. First of all, we have the M4 sedan with the DCT gearbox. Then we have the M4 sedan with the manual gearbox. M4 cabriolet with the DCT gearbox. M4 cabriolet with a manual gearbox. Then we come to the M4 sedan competition package with the DCT. Then again with a competition package but with a manual gearbox. Then the M4 cabriolet competition package with the DCT. Followed by the M4 cabriolet. Try saying that so many times. M4 cabriolet competition package with a manual gearbox. And then we have a new one, you might not have heard of it yet. It's a BMW M4 CS. This kind of fits between the M4 competition package and the M4 GTS. It's in the middle of there. So far that one's only been announced with the DCT gearbox and in coupe form, but hey, they announce things a lot of the time. Then we have the M4 GTS, only with DCT, and the M4 DTM competition package. Or championship, whatever. M4 DTM, let's just call it that. So immediately I'm gonna say, let's cross off the M4 GTS and the M4 DTM, because those were limited numbers and, well, you can't really get them brand new anymore. Just for interest's sake, let's talk about some of the performance figures on the GTS and the DTM. Now they have the same engine. Well, all of them have the same engine, but these also produce the same numbers. 493 brake horsepower or 368 kilowatt and 600 newton meters of torque. Both of these guys are good for a top speed of close to 300 kilometers per hour and 0 to 100 in around the 3.8, 3.9 second range. That's very fast for a small BMW. Performance figures on... Let's start with the smallest ones, or the weakest ones, the M4s, and work our way up to the competition package and then the CS. So all of the normal M4s, they come with 425 bhp, or 317 kilowatt, and 550 newton meters of torque. Their top speed is limited to 250 kilometers per hour. Then we get the competition package, slightly more power, 444 bhp or 331 kilowatt, but the newton meter stays the same at 550 newton meters. Although the top speed was raised just a little bit to 260 kilometers an hour. Then we have the M4 CS. This again has a little bit more power, 460 bhp, 343 kilowatt, and 600 newton meters of torque. Yeah, this thing's top speed is raised again to 280 kilometers per hour. That is a lot of M4 models. That's the paper I had. Okay, which one would I go for? Now, I personally love manual gearboxes and I love cabriolets. So if I was gonna get one, I'd probably go for the M4 competition package cabriolet with a manual gearbox. I think that would be good. But if I had to go for a DCT, I'd probably go for the M4 CS. The reason I'm saying that is, okay, look, it's more expensive than the standard one and the competition package, but okay, it's faster. I think it looks a little bit better. It sounds better, and a lot of the extras and features you can buy on the standard and the competition package, they already come fitted to the CS as stock. So I think you could save a bit there, and a CS is just a bit of a better version. It kind of replaces the old CSL badge. Not exactly, but you can think of it like that. I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it useful. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for more videos.